Hello lovely people, welcome back to my makeup channel. Today I'm going to share some tips and tricks on how to achieve a flawless base. I know a lot of people struggle with their dark circles, with their dark spots, with the pigmentation on their faces, with the red marks, whatever it is. I can answer all of your questions in this video. As you guys can see, I have two different tones on my face right now. Just pause the video down and let me know which one's correct one. This one? That's one. If you want to know about this, then please keep on watching the video. What I'm essentially going to do, I'm going to make the right side, and the left side, the wrong side. So basically, what I'm going to do on this side would be the correct way of putting makeup, correct way in the sense, the kind of process that I would follow, and this would be something that I will not do on my particular skin tone. So you guys can pick up the advices that you guys need if you have been struggling with any of these issues. First things that I do recommend before going in on with any makeup is priming your face. Those very, very crucial steps to prime your face, because your makeup needs something to adhere to. Plus, it also creates like a layer between the makeup and your skin. So either which way, priming is important. So I'm just going to go in with the primer, which is from NYX. This is a photo loving primer. I've been really enjoying this one. I really like it. I'm just going to go in on half my face. And here, I'm not going to do that. Next up, as I have a lot of dark circles, a lot of dark patches, a lot of dark spots, so I do correct my skin before I conceal it. Color correction essentially means to basically negate this particular dark blueness. And you can't really just go in with a concealer. If you are blessed with a flawless skin where you don't have a lot of dark circles, by all means go in with a concealer only. But if you have dark circles like these, you need a heavy duty corrector. So basically what I tend to do is, I apply an orange corrector on my dark circles, around my lips, and on any other dark spots that I need concealed. Now you guys can see I also have some red spots going on. These are mostly fresh pimples, fresh acne. So for anyone who's suffering with covering those, go in with a green corrector. Basically, these are the two colors that negate the redness and the darkness from your skin. I use this from LA Girl, from NYX, from Kryolan. So LA Girl is very readily available. You can get it from Nykaa, you can get it from Chandni Singh, you can get it from New You stores. So LA Girl is definitely one of those things that you can get your hands on pretty easily. So get that and go in with that first on your dark spots, your dark circles, any dark patches on your skin. Which is what I'm going to start with. I'm going to be using the Derma palette from Kryolan, mostly because it has all the shades and I'll be able to depict the mistakes and the correct way of doing my base more aptly to you guys. So first I'm going to go in with orange corrector on my dark circles, around my mouth, even on my nose and on my dark spots. If you have been blessed with flawless skin and you don't really need any kind of correction, by all means go in with a concealer. But you need to be able to really observe your skin and kind of figure out yourself whether you need an orange corrector or not. If you have dark circles like mine, you need an orange corrector. You're not going to let the orange be as orange as this. You definitely need to pat it down to make it more peachy. What I'm using is the YBP sponge. I love this one. You can also pick this up from Chandni Singh Studio. They also have their own website. Either which way. Function of a color corrector is not really to cover up your dark circles. It's basically to cancel them out. The covering part is definitely done with the concealer and not with the corrector. A corrector is mostly to cancel out the blackness and the blueness on your skin. As you guys can already see, it hasn't covered up my dark circles, but it has actually cancelled out the darkness. So even today in India, some people are not really happy with their own skin tone and they want a skin tone which is like 2 to 3 layers lighter than themselves. So one of the things that I really want to point out is, I am a beige skin tone, and if I go in with a lighter concealer, lighter foundation, I'll turn grey. My foundation will not look flawless, it will look grey. So you guys really need to identify what your skin tone is and identify the makeup that goes with it rather than actually just plopping on lighter color concealer or lighter color foundation just thinking it might turn you lighter. It's not going to work that way. So which is exactly what I'm going to depict here. I'm going to show what would happen if you use a lighter color concealer which is a lot lighter than your own skin tone. So here I have color corrected. I'll go in with the D3 concealer from the Derma palette. Now this is the color I won't even highlight with on my face or for my skin tone. So going in with the concealer of this shade will not work for me at all. I'm just going to blend this out. Just a tidbit, if anyone who is watching this video checked out my last post on Instagram where I created the look from the mummy. And where I actually created the mummified look of hers, I actually use this concealer to make myself look great. So, just saying. You guys see this? It does not give me a healthy glow. It makes me look greenish, greyish. Because number one, I have not corrected. Number two, I'm using a concealer that's way too light for my skin. So don't do this. Just don't do this. A lot of people are not really ready to accept their skin tone, which is one of the major things that I actually see here in India, and which is one of the reasons that guys, which is the reason that people pick up incorrect makeup for their skin tone. So I used to do that too, so I don't blame anyone. Before I actually knew about makeup, I used to do exactly that. I used to go in with the lightest concealer, the lightest foundation, thinking it will make me look fairer, but it doesn't work that way. And it does, makes you look grey, that's it. So next I'm going to go in with the D4.5. This is my actual shade for concealing. I'm going to go in on my dark circles. Next up, I'm going to go in with the foundation. I'm going to use the LA Girl mixed with the Loreal Infallible in the shade 320 Caramel Toffee. Okay, so the LA Girl by itself is a little too light for my skin. So I'm going to use that on this side of the face. And I'm going to mix it with the Loreal Infallible in the shade 320 Caramel for this side of my face. You guys can see, it's making me look even grayer because I loaded the already light concealer with an even lighter foundation. I'm going to mix this foundation with the Infallible. So one tip that I can give you guys is whenever you're trying to pick up foundation and you're at the drugstore or whatever, try the foundation on your neck or on your jawline. The thing is, whenever you do makeup, you're supposed to match it with your neck so it doesn't look like a mask. The sensible thing to do is to match it with your neck rather than with your arms, because the shade of your skin tone on your body is very different than what you have on your face. So, just a little tip. So I'm going to go in with this. You don't need to follow all of these steps, of course. Identify your skin, figure out what works for you and go in with that. As you guys can see, I have done no correction here, so my spots, my dark circle, everything is peeking through. And here, the coverage and the flow of the foundation, everything is a lot more settled. So you guys can see the difference yourself. Next up, I'm gonna highlight a tiny bit. Again, I'm gonna go in with a very, very light shade. This is DFD one from the same palette. Obviously, if you're concealing with a lighter shade, you have to go in with an even lighter shade to highlight. So I don't know about the nose. I think I'm gonna leave the nose. I'm just gonna blend this up. This highlighting basically means to bring it forward, contouring means send it backwards. I'll get into the highlighting and the contouring 101 if you guys are interested. If you guys want this as a series, I am definitely into that as well. I can do like an eyeshadow 101, an eyebrow 101, a contouring 101, whatever. So please do let me know if you guys like this kind of series. I can definitely get it up for you guys. Here, I'm going to highlight with D4. I went in with D4.5 to conceal. So for this I'm gonna highlight with D4. Then blending is the key, guys. Don't just leave the product right there, you need to blend it out. There needs to be no sharp line in your makeup, there needs to be a lot of flawless merging between the colors. So, just blend a lot. I love this sponge to blend. This is the YBB one, if I haven't mentioned this already. I do love this one and I've been using it non-stop. I use it on my clients as well. So, I do like it. It's not a sponsored video, I'm not being paid to talk about this, but I do like it because I really thoroughly recommended. I think it's one of those things that's very, you see this, there is not much give in this particular sponge. That's why it gives you like a very flawless, very merged in kind of a look after you complete it. So I do like it. So I'm just going to finish off the rest of my face and be right back. That's how my face looks, complete with a highlight, some contouring, some eyebrows, and the lips.
Yes, you guys can see this makes me look what?
Okay. You can see this makes me look very washed out and very grey, and it's already like greying up, so it makes me look very unhealthy, you know, so to say. And this one, I have a nice clean base. Good glow to my skin, good merging, good everything. So it's very essential to stick to your own skin tone and then work according to that. If you have pigmentation, if you have anything, there's always a way to conceal it. But don't try and go 2 to 3 shades lighter than your skin. You're gonna make yourself look grey. And trust me, in the pictures, it looks even greyer. So be very, very aware of that. Something from this video, do take this. That please be very proud of your skin tone and work according to that rather than trying to achieve the skin tone that you don't have. Your flaws and all would look a lot more hidden if you work with products that actually are for you rather than trying on products that are not for you. You guys can see my spots and all are pretty visible here on this area because I didn't correct them and I went in with a lighter color concealer, which is just highlighting them even more. So just be very aware of that. And if you guys want videos like these, if you guys want more tutorials on like makeup 101s, I can definitely get those up for you guys. Just let me know in the comments down below if this kind of video entertains you and I'll get some more of them up. So till the next time, from the good side of the face,